People, well, they hate what I do. You see, I think the very laws of the universe have something to do with it. It says, wheels plus your feet equals social leprosy. Among the cool kids with their loud tailpipes and their Pac-Man video games, well, they just don't get it. You can be sure there's never going to be any human-sized cardboard cutout of me in the mall, promoting your favorite candy bar. Nuts and nougat? Nope, not for me. I'm not gonna lie. The girls love it when a man flips a fine furnished piece of wood. The charisma of their sport just mesmerizes them. Hot tricks, cool kicks? Really, what just isn't there to love? But listen for a moment. I haven't chosen to skateboard. No, it's not an easier route. No, I do not listen to Nickelback, Blink 182, or POD. No, ESPN is not in my favor. No, I do not like it when people eat loud either. It's just like when they're chewing. It's like they soak their food and their saliva like it's gonna accelerate the flavor. What's wrong with people? Anyway, okay, where am I going with this? Well, I'm a rollerblader. Hey, what's up, Dan?
Hey, hold on a second. Hey, Ben, so how's the video coming along?
Yeah, it's coming along.
Hey, Dan! Get your ass up here and help me with that Wolverine! You just had to buy that thing, didn't you?
Hey, hold on a second.
Oh, God! Oh, God! It's on my arm, Dan! Dan! Ah, my toe! Oh, my toe! Dan, on my toe! Get off my toe, Dan! Oh, God!
Oh, yeah, that, don't worry about that.
Yeah, like I was saying, we finished up your section today, so it's looking really good.
Alright, that's cool. Man, I had the worst day skating ever.
Yeah, why is that?
Man, first, I started out skating at Skate Plaza, and it just was so dumb. These three skateboarders kept coming up to me asking me to do a backflip. Just made this huge deal.
Hey man, what's up? Did you like do a backflip for us?
Yeah, man, backflip.
Every time.
Well, why not, dude? It's just a backflip. You got it.
I'm not gonna do a backflip, guys. Not today.
Hey everybody, this guy's doing a backflip.
Backflip.
Yeah. Backflip. Really?
Yeah, I mean, it's just ridiculous. These kids think that all rollerblading is backflips and spins and just trying to go big and hurt yourself. I don't know, but so basically, I just wanted to get away from them, so I just went around the neighborhood to skate.
Hey, there ain't no skateboarding here. It's not skateboarding. It's rollerblading. Rollerblade. A little fruity, isn't it?
I mean, it's not that hard to tell the difference between the two. Rollerblading and skateboarding, I mean, they're completely different. I mean, one, they're attached to your feet. One, it's not. Sure, we do a lot of the same stuff, like rails, but it's completely different.
So what did you do next?
Man, I just decided to call it a day. I was gonna skate home, but then... What's with the stigma with everybody thinking rollerblading's gay?
Well, Dan, I mean, I don't think you're lame or queer or whatever they said to you. But Andrew did finish your section today, so I'm gonna go ahead and watch that.
All right, Ben. Well, I guess I'll talk to you later.
Damn, Blaine, got my toe, man.
Hold on, God, damn it.
That's looking pretty good.
Yep, yep, sure is. Oh, I like to party. I've got something to put in you.
When I reminisce about growing up as a rollerblader, I realize it hasn't always been easy. There were no undying sequels of video games made after my favorite skater. There were no epic moments in sports history that everyone knew. If I ever saw my favorite rollerblader on a Wheaties box, I'd probably soil myself. Not many people got to truly see what I was into. I was misunderstood, to say the least. I mean, who knew what people thought all these years when I was practicing tricks in my shoes, pretending they were my skates?
Oh, is that poor handicapped kid having muscle spasms?
I often felt like a minority at the skate park. For every 30 little kids with a skateboard, there'd be one rollerblader. I guess it makes sense that they're stuck on every other sport but mine, when all they see is what's on TV. I don't know if rollerblading will ever be accepted in its true form. I wish people would give it a chance and see how much fun it could be. But in the end, I guess people will always miss great opportunities if they don't search for them. Although it is satisfying to know that there are a few younger kids, despite facing disapproval from nearly everyone, decide the search is worth it.
I told you what was gonna happen if you talk with your mouth full. I told you.
The whole of England must be searching for me. Well, sooner or later they're going to find me.
Never. Well, hey there. Hey.
How did you get in here?
How'd you get in here?
I live here.
Well, you're supposed to be skating at 1, and look at the clock, man. It's 4:30, and you're still in bed. Everybody's waiting on us to skate, so why don't we go meet them?
Hmm? All right.
Let's go.
Yeah, let's go. All
right.
Andrew got me thinking. I have some really weird friends through rollerblading.
Then you better be safe on this gap, okay?
Anyone can tell you that common interests bring people together, whether it's playing basketball with your friends or being abnormally obsessed with strategy games.
Okay, meet me in swamp. Yeah, meet me in swamp. Okay, now hand me Spear of Destiny. Yeah, right click on the inventory. Yeah! Yes! John, you're not gonna believe this. I'm a level 60.
But if the popularity isn't as strong, it means even closer bonds. This is certainly true in rollerblading, especially when there is no future in making money. I guess this means it takes a certain level of individualism to rollerblade. It takes someone with enough self-respect to put all their time and energy into such an unpopular activity. This is why it's so natural for me to accept anyone with rollerblades on. I can't possibly imagine going somewhere and seeing someone with rollerblades on and not instantly greeting them.
Hey, rollerblade, huh?
Oh yeah.
Damn right I rollerblade. Just come here.
This bond is a special element in rollerblading. This is why it never fails to amaze me to see how we effortlessly cross the boundaries of where you come from or what you wear. We stretch beyond the setbacks of stereotypes. This is what truly sets us apart as a community. And in the end, I met all my core friends through rollerblading.
Covers.
damn shirt. What? How about pour it on me?
Andrew!
You ever think of how the freedom in rollerblading is kind of like a hot dog? I mean, you can put condiments on it and, you know.
Out of all my friends, Andrew's for sure the strangest. He's absolutely obsessed with the concept of freedom. He loves it so much, he even set up his own patriotic photos to post on his MySpace. Just the other night, I caught him watching his all-time favorite movie, Braveheart.
Yeah. Oh, gets me every time. Oh. Yeah.
His love for freedom makes sense of his desire to rollerblade. He understands the limitations of other sports compared to them. In basketball, you learn how to control a ball. In BMX, you learn how to control your bike. The more I thought about it, I came to realize that in nearly every other sport, you're controlling something outside yourself. This is why Andrew and I love to rollerblade. The sport is truly yours when you're using your own feet. This is why rollerblading is a part of you. And in return, the limitations are blown away. It becomes a personal matter because you realize your true sense of expression and freedom.
Right into a rail, or you can lather it up with some ketchup like you lather up a ledge with some wax. You know, it's a lot like the freedom in rollerblading.
Andrew, that's about the dumbest metaphor I've ever heard.
Well, that's pretty good, rollerblading like a hot dog. I mean, seems to work to me. Hello.
Yep, hot dog was just like rollerblades.
Now, I'm no chef, but I'm pretty sure that wheels aren't supposed to be on a plate.
Aaron Pyle. Who would have thought a kid like that has amazing style? Since rollerblading is a part of you, you can show the whole world your own personal style. Style shines in rollerblading. It's a major aspect of the sport. It reveals character like nothing I've ever seen. Nobody looks the same because they all move so differently.
Far from North America, where the buildings are old, and you might have lots of mimes.
Style becomes so important that it doesn't matter what trick you do, but how you do it. The way you utilize your hands, legs, speed, and landing are just a few examples of what defines your sense of self. Just as people present different clothing styles to distinguish themselves, the personality of rollerblading is revealed through movement.
Hey Aaron, I finished your section.
Sweet.
Looks pretty sick. Oh, I want to see this.
Yeah, yeah.
Dad, how am I supposed to, like, chew these wheels?
You know, I don't know, but you're gay as hell.
We got to do all the land.
After we dropped off Aaron, we headed home. The day was coming to an end, and I couldn't help but think of all that rollerblading has done for me. The first time I put on a pair of skates, I had no clue about the places it would take me and the faces it would help me meet. By choosing to do something different, I was also unknowingly choosing the criticism that came with it too. I think it's important to understand that if you dedicate yourself to something that's overlooked, it'll mean having unwanted confrontations. But it's also important to know that these endeavors are the most rewarding in the end because it's a direct reflection of your independence from popular choice. I stuck with rollerblading through all the ups and downs, and my love for it is untouchable.
Now I've been manning the deep fryer all day down at Long John Silver's, and I come home and you got wheels and bearings sitting on the table.
Rollerblading has taught me many things about life. It showed me that if you truly want something, you must know 100% that your heart is in it. You can't go wrong this way. When all is said and done, this is the most important lesson rollerblading has taught me.
Thank you. curiosity.
Hey, I'm creativity. That's good.